To my YouTube channel, and in today's video I am on the street asking some questions of my Chinese friends just to find out and understand their lives. So first of all,
问你啊，你一个月差不多用多少钱呢？你是学生，一个月差不多用多少钱？
1200人民币。
1200, okay, good. 你是学生，一个月大概用多少钱呢？
大概2000吧。2000？你用2000？做什么？就是有的时候，其实有的时候就是，我都用完了卫生巾，不知道都停到哪里了。OK，没关系，2000差不多，我觉得学生1200，有的学生说1200、1500、2000，对，都听到了。就是。
如果不买什么东西的话，其实是不会花这么多的。对，如果买东西或者甚至有的时候可能出去玩一下，对，是的，会花一点钱。好，谢谢，谢谢。Thank
you so much, Kate. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
OK，好，差不多。你是学生啊，你每个月差不多用多少钱呢？
我父母给我的零用钱大概是2000一个月，但是基本上我会花1000，然后自己再存1000。所以一个月1000块钱就够了啊。第二个是，如果。
All right, so I was saying that, what is the side of my story about budgeting as a student in China? I feel like the thing that really takes up a lot of my money is the food. Recently is the food, because I don't travel. If I do a traveling, it's really on a minimal budget, like going to a certain place. And in recent days, I really don't travel a lot because I have to work like part-time and I have to do some other things, so I really don't have time for traveling. And the other thing is I stopped buying clothes because I just realized it's not really important for me to buy clothes every other time. So what really takes up my money recently is the food. I would go to like Burger King, McDonald's, I don't really do KFC, or like Starbucks, what is the other thing, like some ice cream. Like I'll go for a fancy ice cream day, you know, like I just love ice cream. I love a fancy ice cream, you know. I really do love this type of fancy food, you know. It's an obvious thing, like we all do like that type of fancy good type of food, because they're just days when you're like craving good things and you just want to treat yourself. So that's what takes up a lot of my money as of recent. So I realized like I cook as well. I cook so much. However, still, if I buy a lot of any other fast food, like if I go out and just buy momentum, like these good, nice restaurants, I realize I could use a lot of money. But on an average month, if I don't use a lot of money, I've tried to use 600 renminbi for 1 month, which was really constrained. I didn't have to buy a lot of ice cream. I didn't have to buy a lot of good food, like apart from my own cooking, from my own good food cooking. I still have to buy that food from the restaurants, you know. And I tried to use 600. 600 renminbi for a student, I know definitely would be enough. If you're even going to like your school cafeteria, or just eating really using the money under the budget, because also there's public transportation, which is really super convenient. As a student, if you're not doing a lot of things, 600 is enough. That's just the basic minimum amount you can go for a month. Some people even go to 500 renminbi. I had that. So I tried 600 and it worked out, but I really didn't enjoy it. Like, I didn't really have a fancy life. And then now I'm using 1000 renminbi for a month because I just felt like 600 was too little. And I still have those days when I just want to treat myself and feel so extra special through food, of course. So I think 1000 renminbi for a student is pretty much enough. So yeah, budgeting for a student in China, I think you could start from 1000, and pretty much 1000 is okay, it's enough. And scholarship wise, you can get enough money and you still have a little money to save for your other extra adventures, like traveling to nearby countries, traveling within China, and just doing a lot of adventurous things, and also starting a business from your own scholarship money. How about that? Okay guys, so this is all I have on budgeting for a student in China. If you do want to continue the conversation, leave me a comment in the comment section, and don't forget to like, subscribe to my YouTube channel. Until my next video, so do stay humble, stay positive, and work hard towards your goal. Thank you so much. Bye.